Well, welcome to our Friday prayer time. This is the last Friday of Lent before we begin Holy Week. And as I've been doing, I've been using my hymnal to make it for our time of prayer to our Lord, and also sharing some special prayer requests. Now, this next week, we're going to begin this weekend with Palm Sunday, the celebration of the triumphal entry, but also the reading of the Passion of our Lord as he is in Jerusalem, and the chief priests, the scribes, the Roman authorities get to the point of sentencing him to death. Now, all this we know is part of God's plan. And so as we watch, as we listen, as we experience the events of this week, we're mindful of the fact that our Lord is enduring all of this out of his great love for us and out of his willingness to sacrifice his life so that we might be forgiven, so we might have life. And so this prayer I want to use today is hymn number 440, Jesus, I Will Ponder Now. And in that, I also want to include a couple of prayer requests. First off, my brother Tim. Tim's father just received his crown of glory yesterday. He passed on from this life to be with his Lord and Savior in heaven. Donald was his name, and I had the joy of being able to have communion with Donald just about a week and a half ago at BWMC. But now, I want to pray that peace be upon the entire Merritt Ohana, their entire family, and also prayers of thanksgiving, although it's still a long road ahead for our brother Paul. Paul has been battling COVID-19. He's been over at BWMC as well. But now he is COVID clear, which is good, and he's on the mend. But it is a long road ahead, for he's been in the ICU for almost 5 weeks. So we'll continue to keep in our prayers Paul and his wife Celeste, Tim and his entire family at the loss of his father Donald. And I want to use for our prayers today hymn number 440. So if you just bow your head and join with me in a prayer as I speak the words of this hymn. Jesus, I will ponder now on your holy passion. With your spirit me endow for such meditation. Grant that I in love and faith may the image cherish of your suffering, pain, and death, that I may not perish. Make me see your great distress, anguish and affliction, bonds and stripes and wretchedness, and your crucifixion. Make me see how scourge and rod, spear and nails did wound you, how for them you died, O God, who with thorns had crowned you. Yet, O Lord, not thus alone, make me see your passion, but its cause to me make known, and its termination. Ah, I also, and my sin, wrought deep your deep affliction. This indeed the cause has been of your crucifixion. Grant that I your passion view with repentant grieving. Let me not bring shame to you by unholy living. How could I refuse to shun every sinful pleasure, since for me God's only Son suffered without measure? If my sins give me alarm and my conscience grieve me, let your cross my fear disarm, peace and conscience give me. Help me see forgiveness won by your holy passion. If for me he slays his Son, God must have compassion. Graciously my faith renew, help me bear my crosses, learning humbleness from you, peace mid pain and losses. May I give you love for love, hear me, O my Savior, that I may in heaven above sing your praise forever. Amen. I forgot to mention, wanted to also keep Miss Sue in my prayers. I heard that Sue, who I think you're on with me right now, watching, keeping you in prayer, because I was made known that you went to the hospital. Hopefully you're doing well. We'll keep you in prayer this next weekend as well, and I'll try to give you a call on your cell if that works out well. Sorry, I guess the interaction of our thing here. Well, thank you for joining me today for a time of prayer. Continue to pray, and if you would like, over these next few days of Holy Week, pull out your hymnal, turn to the Holy Week hymns or even the Lenten hymns, and make those your prayer each day. Looking to the cross, looking to the altar, where God's Son is given for you and for me. We'll talk to you soon, Sue. God bless, and have a wonderful day. Aloha.